give you a prayer point that you will be praying for that person, and you will be praying for the other person, and then you will call yourselves later to find out within the week to find out if that is done. Do you understand? Okay. Hallelujah. I'm feeling that we should start it now. The thing is just pushing me to say it. Just pushing me. Okay, I think I have said it.
Don't go to left. If the person by your right is your family member, then go front. Then, so you don't need to get up. Oh yeah.
The prayer point right now. Where's the key? What? Covenant keeping. Collect somebody's number. I want to give you a prayer point. That will be your prayer point for this week. You are the covenant keeping God. Don't ask me for my own. All of you are my prayer partner. Covenant keeping God. Amen. Yes. You are. That's okay. That's okay. No. Go to where you were. Yeah, Arabash. Don't collect from your wife, oh. My brother, my sister, look back. There's somebody behind. Okay, beautiful. Connect. Here we are, standing in your presence. Here we are, standing in your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory, come down. Here we are, standing in His presence. Here we are, standing in Your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory, come down. Here we are, standing in Your presence. Here we are, standing in Your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah glory.
Oh, yeah, we are.
Here we are, standing in Your presence. Here we are, standing in Your presence. Shekinah glory, come down. Shekinah.
I'll give you some time. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. Now here is the prayer point. 2 Corinthians chapter 10. I want to read from verse 3. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war according to the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God for pulling down strongholds, casting down imaginations or arguments and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, bringing every thought into captivity to the obedience of Christ. Now here is the prayer point. I hope we take note of this. You are praying for the person whose number you have taken and name. Don't just take number and name. You are bringing down strongholds. Every stronghold against that brother or against that sister. That's your prayer this week. You are going to call him and say, I'm praying for you. Can pray it in the afternoon, pray it in the morning, can pray it in the night. So you have 7 days to do that. Say, we meet again on Sunday by his grace for another one. Strongholds. Everything standing against that brother is your assignment this week. Everything standing against that sister is your assignment this week. Thoughts on high things. Fahata Misia Krabashka. So, Freddy Hiyalashka. Let me give you 1 minute to pray that prayer right now before you go home. Bahata kata kata kata. Brusi Efe Ane Akate Asha. Katata Avreta Atesha. Elebelebe se prepete kepete pete 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 pete. Everything that is called stronghold, standing against you, militating against you, every kepeta poche. Everything working against your life, spirit, soul, and body, raise a standard in righteousness. Bring them low. Whatever it is, however it's coming from any quarter, Alabata Shalashka, we bind the stronghold of the enemy. It shall not stand up, prosper, or prevail against you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. In Jesus' name we have prayed. You are blessed. So take home prayer. Amen. 7 good days. Wow. Pray that for somebody. 7 good days. By next Sunday, the person should give testimony. Yes. Pray it on Sunday. You have started now. Pray it on Monday or pray it on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday before you come. You know, I don't just do things. It's by the Spirit. All right? Those who know me know that I don't just jam things to do. Let's see what God will work out of this. Amen. So today is last Sunday of the month. It's an interaction time. And then we're having questions and answers. So, as I answer the questions, you can take note of anything you need to take note of, because that is the message for the day. That is what we do every last Sunday of the month. To encourage you to read your Bible at home, to also encourage you to be part of what we do here, the life class and the messages, to also encourage you to take the word of God seriously, because by it we grow and make progress. Hallelujah. All right, let's go. Yeah.
Some people's tongue in some quarters sounds like Muslims praying. Are we also supposed to learn that tongue? Is it part of the tongue that we are discussing?
Are we also supposed to
learn that tongue that sounds like Arabic rhymes.
Thank you. First and foremost, we don't learn tongues. Mahaka Fradi Katapa Erena Kapa Ta Ta Efranta Kase. I don't know whether it's Arabic or Portuguese or Igbira. The point is, tongue is by the Spirit. Mark chapter 16 says, from verse 17, it talks about he will give you a new tongue. Alright? This sign will follow those who believe. In my name they will cast out demons and they will speak with new tongues. You don't learn it. You don't copy it. And it's not your business whether it's Arabic. Arabic is a language. So Arabic is a tongue of men. In Acts chapter 2, from verse 4, on that day when the Holy Ghost came upon them, they didn't speak tongues of angels, not this type I'm speaking. They spoke languages spoken by men. And everybody around heard them speaking their own languages. And they heard them glorifying the name of God with their tongues. So, whether it's Arabic, it's welcome. Whether it's Portuguese, is welcome. But you do not copy tongues and you do not learn tongue. Is that okay? That was what I heard. Read it again.
There are some churches that they have this type of flow. They call it Emi.
Emi?
Yeah. So, when the spirits, there is a particular way.
That means the question was
there's a way they do their own. They have a, and it sounds alike, the same, almost all the time. Hello, 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 hello. They will. So the mama is now asking.
Okay.
Is that part of that speaking in tongue thing?
Okay. So next time, write the question, make it holistic. Now, on that, I think somebody asked that question in our review yesterday. And this was the answer I gave. Speaking in tongues is not human idea. Tongue is a language orchestrated by the Spirit of God. You don't copy it. You don't learn it. However, there are some churches or denominations where they have kind of gotten a particular type for themselves. And that kind of tongue, there is, because it is not scriptural, anything that is not scriptural, that is not scripture based, should be discarded. Do you understand? Should be discarded. However, like I also told them, there could be influence by the Spirit that rub off on people that make their tongues sound alike, but is different from the type you are mentioning now. Again, we should also note that strange spirits can also give people enablement to speak in tongues because it's a language. Holy Ghost can orchestrate it. Evil spirits can also orchestrate their own type. Egg. That is strange spirits. That they put it inside egg or put it inside bottle or rub anything on it to give you so that you eat it and then you'll be able to manifest. That is strange spirits. It is an evil spirit. That cannot be Holy Ghost. And then don't be confused by such people saying what is right about you. Now there's a spirit scripture called familiar spirits. Familiar spirits know things about people. And that is why they call them familiar. They are familiar with people. For example, in the book of Acts, when Paul was ministering, there was a girl that was moving around with Paul. And the girl kept speaking things. And what was she saying? These are the servants of God that have come to teach us the right way of the Lord. What she was saying was accurate. What she was saying was correct. But the spirit using her to say those things was a wrong spirit. So the point here is that there are wrong spirits that could move on people to say what is right. It is not what is accurate that is the issue now, but the spirit that is orchestrating it. Is that okay? So stay away from all such manifestation and manipulation of the devil against the human soul. Is that okay now? So I understand there are such things. It happens in some places, but they are always strange. Don't go there and you have no business with them. Is that okay? And don't get carried away that somebody is telling you what is correct. Sometimes, Apostle Paul himself, not the day that the girl started speaking, that he casted out the demon. So you have to also wait in the spirit to be sure what is happening. When the Holy Ghost now showed to him that this was a strange spirit, then he now got up and rebuked that spirit. And you know the trouble that followed it when he rebuked that spirit? Because the girl was making money for her boss. Our boss had to stir up riots against Apostle Paul. They beat them to the point of death. You understand? So there are strange spirits. So when you hear people talk, and the things he's saying looks or sound correct, please don't be carried away. Facts are different from truth. Facts are different from truth. They can use those facts to entrench you in death. Your soul can be captured. You understand? And what they do in such places, they give you what seems to be a solution. Then you join them. Then they add more problem. You are never free. Because you must keep on coming to them for solution. You get the point now? Of course, having said that, the Holy Spirit can also move on a person to speak any language on the earth. Anyone, even if it's Arabic. Arabic language is like saying Yoruba. Arabic is like Yoruba. It's a language spoken by the Arabs. Do you get it clear? Yeah. Let's take the next one.
If you are repeating a particular prayer, does that mean you do not have faith?
Okay. I think I heard that time. Praise the Lord. He said, some people said that that Christians don't have faith. Right? Yeah. I think I heard that prayer. And my mind started working on that prayer, on that question. To anybody that tells you Christians don't have faith, tell him that he doesn't know who a Christian is. Let me start before I come to the question. He says, some people say Christians don't have faith. That was what I heard. I heard that question myself. That he said, Christians don't have faith. Why are they repeating what they have said? That you are a Christian, meaning you are a faith person. Yoruba calls you Onigbagbo. What is Igbagbo? Faith. So don't commit the sin of Adam and Eve. The devil came and he said, if you eat it, you will be like God. And they were already like God. So what else would they become? So someone is saying, you Christians don't have faith. That I'm a Christian, meaning that I have faith. I have become believer. The man who is out there who does not believe is unbeliever. He is the one who doesn't have faith. That you are a Christian already means that you are a child of God and God is your father. That's the beginning of the relationship. But you may now not develop the relationship. A person can marry and not develop relationship with his wife, but he has a wife for 5 years, he's been married. But there might not be a relationship between him and his wife. The only relationship they have is wedding. That's what some people have, wedding. After wedding, there is no relationship. Same thing, some people can be children of God. After being a child of God, there is no relationship. So you are now to deliberately build up that relationship with your father. Do you understand? Now, in Mark, is it chapter 9 or chapter 11? If you shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed. Chapter 11. Be thou removed. If any of you shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and should not doubt in his heart, he shall have what? Whatsoever he says. Hallelujah. Do you understand? I say that whoever shall say unto this mountain. Now, the place of repetition is a different issue. In Matthew chapter 6, Jesus, the disciples came to him, Matthew chapter 6, and said, teach us how to pray. And then Jesus was teaching them how to pray. And part of what Jesus corrected was not what they called vain repetition. What is a vain repetition? A vain repetition is a word that is not targeted. Word that has no target. It's just like you have, the Bible says, be careful what you say. He said, because every idle talk shall be judged. So vain repetition is an idle talk. What makes it vain is idle. Idle means it's not hitting any, there's nothing it's achieving. It's idle. You know, you also have, okay, let me bring it down. You know, you have idle money. It's your money, but it's not, doesn't have targets. Some of your friends, if you have friends, like I have some friends who will say, hey, Joe, you have any idle money? Or they will use the word spare money. They are trying to say, do you have any money that is not really having targets? Sorry, yeah, me, no? They say, okay, how much? Only 20,000. Ah, the idle one I have is 2 naira. Or 200 naira. And you are talking 20,000. Are you with me? But there are friends who have idle funds of 20 million. Or any. Idle funds, you know, the one that I can give, quickly give you for 1 year. Sorry, loco, dakwa, dakoni, nitre, koni, collateral, nothing. Idle. In the same way, there are idle words. Words that are not targeted. I mean, that at anything. So, vain repetition is, though are those words that are not born out of faith. Only if you're a Christian, man, so when you're mad, ni oruko Jesu, ni oruko Jesu, ni oruko Jesu. Shami ne meta, ami, ami, ami. Aya, better again. Ni oruko Jesu. Those are vain repetitions. But if I say, in the name of Jesus, I want this mountain to move and be cast into the sea. Nehevraska, I command you to move in the name of Jesus. After speaking that and have a release in my heart, or there is no time to continue, I pause. Go and do other things. I will come back again and continue on that same spot. That is not a vain repetition. Why? Because when you speak, you are supposed to speak the word of God to that mountain. Say, you know, I read a scripture. It says, you shall have what you say. But I have taught you in this church, if you remember, I did a study on that some time ago, that what you say is able to move mountain when what God says is what you say. That is why you just get up now and speak to any tree there and see whether it will move. Yet it says you shall have what you say. So in the place of prayer, excuse me, we also build up faith. Excuse me. We also build up what? Faith. You say it and keep saying it until your faith will come. We call it confession. Do you get it? Confession. It's not your word you are confessing. It is the word of God. Now in Ecclesiastes, it says, when the cloud is full of rain. Chapter 8 or so. Check it out. Ecclesiastes. I hope you are taking note. I'm already preaching. As I answer the question, the message is coming. Amen. When the cloud is full of rain, what will happen? It will empty itself upon the earth. Now, it takes time for it to be full of rain. What that means is that you keep on saying it. It's called what? Confession. It doesn't mean lack of faith. Now, that is not in every case. Thank you. Chapter 11, verse 3. If the clouds are full of rain, they empty themselves upon the earth. And if a tree falls to the south or to the north, in the place where the tree falls, there it shall lie. Until then, Job 14:14. It says, I will wait. Look for it. Let me see if I'm quoting correctly. Until my change comes. Thank you. That is it. If a man dies, shall he live again? All the days of my hard service, I will wait till my change comes. So what is the point of, at what point are you waiting? We wait upon the word of God. And you keep saying it until you see it manifest. Then Luke chapter 18, the impenitent, the unjust judge, that impenitent prayer, or woman rather. Remember that story? Where a woman kept on coming to a judge and said, avenge me my cause. Avenge me. And the judge there was likened to God and the woman was likened to you. Right? And then the judge said, for the sake of her, look for that please, her continuous coming, lest she weary me, let me answer her. So when you say it, it doesn't mean lack of faith, and you say it again. You keep saying it until you see it. Alright? That is at the point of confession. But when you pray, prayer is turning your confession into revelation. That's prayer. So sometimes when you are confessing, it's a form of prayer, but it's different from when your spirit begins to deal with the mystery of what you are confessing. You confess is one thing. I shall live, I shall not die. Will you say, because you said it last year, this year, will you say it again? Huh? I shall live, I shall not die. Will you say, because you said that same thing last year, this year, to avoid repeating yourself, you won't say it again? No. It is the word of God, not your word. Then your spirit takes that word and becomes a revelation. Pray it out until you see effects. Where did I say she opened to? Sarah? Luke 18. I think we have read that. Okay, 18. Thank you. Yet, because this widow troubles me, I will avenge her. Lest she, blessed by what? Please note that and give to the person who told you that Christians don't have faith. It is a continual coming. Jesus, in the book of Matthew, got to the Garden of Gethsemane and took a prayer point for 3 hours. And then he would come to the disciples. Can't you watch with me for an hour? But he went for 3. After he will wake them, they will sleep again, and he will go back to repeat the same prayer. What's the prayer point? If it be your will, let this cup pass. He prayed that prayer 3 hours, 1 hour per session. And hoping that the disciples will join them. But those guys, their eyes, scripture says, was heavy with sleep. So they couldn't watch. So that's why scripture says, watch and pray. So please, don't mind them. Alright? Stay on it until you see. And this is a particular kind of prayer. You can walk in intercession. You're interceding for somebody. You can also walk in petition. You can also walk in... what's the other one? Supplication. You get it? You can also work in prayer of agreement. When two people come together to agree and say they are on a matter until, for example, when you see countries open, nations open, a society open, so people have been on their knees talking about the same matter. Yeah. Let Ondo open for the gospel. Let Ondo open for the gospel. Will you say, because you said it last year, you will not say it again this year? No. Until you see Ondo opens for the gospel. There are many examples I could give you, but that is okay for that question. We are blessed. Amen? Amen. All right.
At what point do I need to start thanking God for a request?
At the point when your heart is your spirit. At the point when your heart comes to rest. There are 2 ways we give thanks. First, we give thanks at the beginning of the prayer. Psalm 100. You shall enter his gate with what? Thanksgiving. And into his court with what? Praise. But by the time you are not dealing with that particular issue, At that point, when your heart comes to rest on that issue, start giving praise. So thanks. Sometimes, as you start the prayer, it's done. In Daniel chapter 10, when Daniel began to pray, something happened. Scripture says, the very day that he began to pray, God heard and God sent answers. And also, what happened immediately? Did the prayer come? Did the answer come? No, because there was one called Prince of Persia. Prince means chief, meaning the chief in charge of Persia. Not Amoba. Prince there means chief, meaning that demon, that devil, in the chief in charge. You know, it's a military term. You know, it is a military, you have chief of staff, chief of air staff, chief of army staff, chief of naval staff. So it is that same language chief they use there, not chief of a Oluwo of Owo. What do you call that? Your chief has a title. I saw you too. Don't worry, not today. Praise God. So it doesn't mean the one that KBSC has given honorary whatever. No. Chief there means the one who is in charge. He's the one supervising the environment. Don't you know there's a chief in Nigeria? For the way Nigeria is going, you know that somebody is controlling these things. All this evil wickedness going. There must be a chief there. Not partial. This one is chief of Nigeria. Controlling wickedness here. We have to pray until that chief will come down. Like they pray in that Daniel. He said it took him 21 days. 21 days. Abi? Yes. 21 days of fasting and praying. 21. You will be, it will interest you to know what was the prayer point. The same thing happened to them. After in that same Daniel, they had the prophecy said they should spend 70 years in Babylon. After 70 years, they were still in Babylon. They were not free. And then the Bible says, and Daniel was reading in the books, and then he found out by books that these guys were supposed to be there for how many years? 70. And they were still in bondage. And the Bible says he took it up and began to intercede. So what do you think was the prayer point? The same prayer point. Only God knows for how long he prayed it until help came. Is that not so? We are blessed. Amen. So what, have I answered that question?
What is God's gain in the place of prayer?
Don't you understand that it is the joy of a father to have his children come to him? It's the joy of every father. God is a father. So that is why I like what they told you in the morning during the life class. So many of you miss life class. Please don't miss that class. If you just come to attend service and you miss the life class, you have missed a large chunk of the entire service. And that part is what we have put together to systematically help you make progress spiritually. You see, what we do when we preach here is called celebration. You have missed the teaching part. You are coming to the point of celebration. Here, we are dealing with every kind of issue and everybody. Yeah, are you with me, somebody? But you have missed the critical part that is organized for your growth and development. Now, what is God's gain? God's gain is your gain. Whatever it's your gain in it is God's gain. Apart from the fact that he enjoys you coming to him as a father, beyond that, when you have joy, God has joy. God is glorified. When your life is better, God is glorified. Is that not true? And when your life is also the other way around, God is abused. Someone is and if God is really God in your life, you know, they are really challenging God in your life. So God has so much to gain. Why you must have victory? God has so much to gain. And beyond that, your testimony will become an avenue for salvation. When it really happens, many souls will become Christians because of you. The book you are reading, don't you know it's a compilation of testimonies? Yeah. The book you are carrying, this Bible, is a compilation. Things you read, there were things that happened to people. They were not concocted. Right? If they didn't stay, like Hebrews chapter 11, if they didn't stay with God. I love most in the whole of Hebrews chapter 11. It says, and Sarah counted God faithful. See that? That became a testimony that anybody who reads it, that God is faithful. So you can you see that God has been glorified by Sarah having a baby? So God will be glorified when your needs are met. So please keep going to God. Don't run away. Don't stop. Amen.
How can I be still in the presence of God? How can I train my mind to receive from God in the place of prayer?
Now, when you come to the place of prayer, one, you must understand that there are different types of prayer. One is congregational prayer. You see, this kind of congregational prayer, they are prayer points raised there, are prayer points for the service, or more so for maybe individuals that have challenges here and there. Are you with me? We call that one public prayer. But beyond public prayer, there is also what we call private prayer. What did I call it? Come on, can you shout it? No, you are not shouting. You see, the one you do in the morning, do in the night, in the afternoon, anytime, it's your private prayer. Now, the place to develop hearing God and the place to develop waiting in the spirit is in your private prayer. Did you hear me? If you have not developed it in your private prayer, you can't bring it to a public place. Hallelujah. So how do you how do you become still in the place of prayer? Now, to be able to hear God. Now, being still in the place of prayer is not primarily keeping quiet and closing your lips. Hello? Hello? In Romans chapter 8, verse 26 says, can we read together? Romans chapter 8, verse 26. Everybody follow this. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. Likewise, the Spirit also does what? Helpeth our infirmities. Stop. The Spirit is the one that does what? Helps our infirmities. Now, infirmities, another word for infirmities are what? Weaknesses. Infirmities are weaknesses, and these more often are weaknesses of the flesh. We also have weaknesses of the soul. But it's the Holy Spirit that will help you. Now, that Holy Spirit cannot jump on you to help you. This is how He helps you. When you begin to take time to give the word attention to the Word of God, hear me and hear me well, everybody. Ushers, please help those who may be tired. If you are tired, you can just get up and walk to the back. Amen? Now, to be able to come to the place of being still, because the idea I want to correct right now is people think that God will speak from above your head. Let me correct that. Under the Old Testament, we had cases like that. God spoke audibly. Even in some instances in the New Testament, God has also spoken audibly. But those audible voices are not the primary way by which God speaks. There was a time I taught us here how to be led by the Spirit of God. There were 4 points I gave us, if you remember. That was about 4 years ago. How to be led by the Spirit of God. I gave you 4 major points that day. I know some people have forgotten. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Now, but however, that we today is not for quiz, okay? The point I'm making now is that when they say be still, Scripture says, be still and know that I am the Lord. It's not just being quiet and being inactive. And then be expecting an audible voice. My son, please don't build your life around that. I'm not saying God can't speak audibly, right? But don't build a life around that. I am going this way because I want to explain to you what it means rest.
when he's talking about rest, it's not la 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 la. Come on, sorrow. Hello, Shesha, go to my social. School fees in you, 12,000 you. Doesn't it look? Angels will be laughing because you have become a comedian. And they will be touching Jesus. You mean you died for this one too? And they won't come back. Now, this is the place of rest. First is that you must be familiar with the word of God. What did I say? Yes, be familiar with the word of God. Now, when it comes to taking out an issue in prayer, take time to find out what the word of God says about that issue. For example, you want to marry. Every person you tell is telling you no. Even the one that smiled with you last Sunday, you were too convinced. You now got there. You get discouraged. The point I'm making is that find out what does the word of God say about marriage and about you being married, or you need a child. What does the word of God say about being pregnant and having a baby? Find out what the word of God has said. Now, arm yourself with those information, because it is the word of God you are dealing with, not your word. You hear me? Arm yourself. Now, don't forget, I've also told you earlier that you have infirmity. Some people deceive themselves and say, no, I'm strong. I know you are strong. That's what the word of God says. But there are infirmities. You have infirmities of the flesh, infirmity of the soul. Now, those word of God you have armed yourself with, when you now come to the place of prayer, as you begin, I know I told you, when you speak the word of God back to God, it's called confession. Am I communicating? When you speak the word of God back to God, or you speak it to a condition or a situation, it is called what? Confession. Come on, are you with me? It is called what? Confession. It is called confession. Don't forget, he is also the high priest over your confession. Right? But your confession is a form of prayer, but it's not the interaction. When you confess, you are not yet interacting. Oh Lord, your word says by his stripes I'm healed. By his stripes I'm healed. Your word says by his stripes I'm healed. I'm still telling him what his word says. By his stripes I'm healed. It has not yet become a revelation. I have not yet engaged that your word says. Sheikh Bobeng, I hope you are following me. Okay, your word says. What am I doing, sir? I am confessing. I am confessing. Now, what does confession do? Confession builds my faith and brings God's word to the situation. Now I am going to turn that confession into a grinding. What I mean by grinding? That intercession. That place where I now begin to turn into a revelation, where I begin to pray, where my heart begin to get engaged on that word that I was confessing. As I engage in it, I still maintain my confession. Even when I'm done praying, as I step out of my house, I cannot be speaking in tongues and shouting on the street everywhere as I go. I maintain my confession. Do you understand the point? I maintain my confession. Now, depending on what you are bringing before God as an issue, that will determine whether you will not need to take time off to either add fasting or add other stuff. You get the point now? So it is in the place of prayer, as your spirit is engaging and you are praying, that you now begin to find stillness in your heart. That is your spirit. If you do not find that stillness inside and you stop to wait, you won't hear nothing. If after today, you don't have, testimony must follow you. Say amen.
Amen.
So you don't just say pray, and then you stop, and then you are looking. Mm-mm. It is the spirit that will bring. Look, take me to that scripture. Say, be still and know. That's the word. Be still and know. Now, it is when they now want to, sometimes they want to change the gear for you in that prayer. Because Romans 8:26 says, is by the Spirit. Even when you groan, is by the Spirit. You don't form groaning. Yala bala 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 bala. Ah! Ah! Kilo ashe bai. Okay. It is the spirit that is now helping your own spirit to groan. The reason for groaning is evident that you want to deal with issues that are not articulated. What does it mean articulate? Articulate means that can be put in structure and in grammar or in language. You now get your spirit want to now say, bring out depth. Have you seen somebody bleeding? Sometimes the blood keeps flowing. When what science people or medical people call blood clotting. When clotting is coming out, there's a difference. Oh, may you not see bleeding, amen? No problem. But you shall get what I'm trying to say. Groaning is clotting. Something heavy is coming. Your spirit is hitting something, and you lack articulate language, and then it can come in form because there is groan. Groan is coming from pain or burden. So it's coming, that is that burden that now forms whatever sound that follows. I know churches where they all form their own groaning. In fact, from the pulpit, they teach them how to groan, and they all learn it a particular style. Yes. So, but I'm saying many things together now. You are all learning. I hope you are learning. Can I hear amen?
Amen?
So when that groaning comes, even you cannot stop it. You can only try to control it. That's how you know you are really groaning in the spirit. Now, what is the rest there? I told you, when your spirit is bringing a feedback or is changing gear, you experience rest. Read that prayer point. I mean, read the question again. That is when you come to, that's when you come to the place of being still. That is one aspect of that question. You get that? Second point of being still, and that is it. Psalm 46 verse 10. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. Second aspect of being still is not being troubled. Meaning you have taken up that issue with God and you have prayed over it and you have found rest in your heart about that issue, then don't be troubled. You have come to the place of still and maintain your confession until you see it come to pass. That is still. So to be still doesn't mean you are not going to office, you are not going to school, you are a student, you lose your lectures. You see, there is testing. No, I'm not going for tests. I'm still before the Lord. If God doesn't move, I will move God. Go ahead and move Jehovah. Let us see how powerful you are. So to be still is also means to rest upon that word, and you are not troubled. Does that make sense to you now? But there are times when there are real trouble. Yeah. Hey. Has somebody fainted before you before and you have to pray to revive? I know some of you have not experienced such things. Some of us have experienced a few things. And then we got there. At that time, because of the present situation, the first thing that stares at you is scare. Am I communicating? The first thing that stares at you is what? Scare. Sometimes fear may come. From experience I'm talking now. Scare, fear. Then in the midst of that, you start. Because you already have an experience of God, that there is nothing impossible for him to do. So, you try close your eyes and remove your focus from that damning experience. And then go back to the experience of good you had before of God. Based on the word of God. It's like in the spirit you are turning your back against the dead man. Or against the situation. Although you are facing it, but you are turning your back. Concentrating now on the one, what you know. You have a child. Suddenly the child is developing temperature. And they are put on manner of cloth and do everything. And then while your husband is putting cloth, the mother is doing a thermometer. You know, most mothers are thermometers. You that is your call. Imagine you are the one. They have been teaching you how to pray here now. You don't take it serious. The day your wife will shout, "Oh, come here!" Oh, they are talking about that. And they can even go to the church. But why? Ah, sweetheart, honey, sugar, Milo. You see, the thing is going on. Hey, you know, women are emotional. So by the time you are saying, "Don't worry, the Lord is in control." Hey, the Lord is in control. He's asking you. He said, "I know my God. Ah, your God has better do this now." It has turned to your God. Your God has better do something now. Honey. The leg is on the honey, can't you see? Ah, you are trying to remove your eyes and she's pulling your eyes back there. You see why your heart must be filled with the word of God. You are a husband here now. You don't have time for the word of God. Can you call you in Jesus' name? I pray nobody will ask you, call your God. Honey. Are you with me, somebody? So at such point, you find that you have to remove your focus from there and put it on what you know of God. And then put it on what, because you have been used to scripture, one or two scriptures will immediately pop up. It is on that you stand. Sometimes you may not even stand fully, but just take the first step. Ayaya, Alada, Alashka, by his stripes. You begin from there. From there, they leap you again. Put another one. Ayere Egadaga. We have passed from death to life. You stay under Agada. As you go, they move you again. Boom. But he took your place that you might take his place. They start pulling scripture. But I niko oka. Oni Rebeke. Wala maiti kboju. Read it. Stay with it. Store it. You have somebody who is a wicked person come to do business with you. Only to shake your hand after business. And from that day your business started nosediving. What do you do? You put your things there for sale. Other people put their own there for sale. Your own has been there for the last 1 week. Nobody's asking you how far. What do you do? You see these things, the way they work. So, they that know their God. First, the book of Daniel says, they that know their God. First, they will be what? Strong. And then they will now do exploits. Exploits are there to be done. And you are the one that will do the exploits. You hear me? So that is how to do it. It is in that place as you are speaking, the now start speaking, and then you now hear what the Spirit of God is saying about that matter. Sometimes it moves you to change the prayer point. Sometimes it tells you what it's saying right there. Sometimes you don't even hear anything at all. You pray and get the matter settled, then you move to something else. I think I've done justice to that. We are blessed. Amen. Come on, say, I'm blessed. Shout it, I'm blessed.
Blessed.
So when you say be still, I've told you what it means, right? Say amen. Please read the next one.
If I do not pray in tongues and I'm asking God for something, would God still answer?
Yes. Yes. The essence of praying in tongues, you were taught this morning that when you pray in tongues, you are able to pray in the spirit. Meaning that it's not every issue that you just come to God and say, God, I need money, and then you get the money like that. There are issues that require revelation. There are issues that require mysteries. Those ones you cannot handle with Yoruba, and you cannot handle with English. Do you understand? It doesn't mean God will not hear you. When you pray in English and your prayer is by the Spirit, it's different from when you pray with the tongue that you are supposed to be speaking, communicating with God. Do you understand? So meaning that even when you pray in English, your English prayer can be in the Spirit. But before it comes into the Spirit, your spirit must have taken over that language. That's what do you get the point I'm making? Your spirit, that is born again spirit, must have taken over the language you want to speak. Even when you don't speak it in tongues, that your spirit can take over that language and put in forces of the word of God, power to cause that word to be heard and cause answer to come. So you are not praying in tongues, yet you are getting results. It's also different from to pray with tongues. To pray with tongue puts you in the spirit and deal with mysteries beyond what your natural eyes can see. Issues beyond what your physical experience are showing to you. Do you get the point now? So this is why you must pray in tongues. The Bible tells you don't forbid to pray in tongues. 1 Corinthians chapter 14. Verse, is it 29 or so? Or 39. Don't forbid to pray in tongues. Do not forbid to pray in tongues. Verse 39 or 29. The last, second to the last verse. Do not forbid it. Pray in tongues. Okay, that's it. 39. Therefore, brethren, desire earnestly to prophesy and do not forbid to speak with tongue. The next question. I hope we are learning something.
Yes, sir. What is the place of confession, meditation, and rhema in the place of prayer?
I think I've answered that earlier. I've told you what confession does. What meditation, when you are praying, it is not in the place of prayer that you meditate. Not that you cannot do it, but you are wasting time. You are supposed to have been meditating before you come to the place of engaging in prayer. Right? So meditation is to take the word of God and chew it with your mind. Chew with your mind. You see, chew with your mind. Chew. So the word meditate also means to stare. Take it over and over, over and over. By his stripes, I'm here. There, by his stripes. Sometimes you even ask that thought a question to be able to get a better answer to keep you alive to the truth of that word. The truth of that word, the revealed word that is coming from that scripture is called Rhema. Rhema is revelation. And you need revelation to be able to address issues properly. So you don't take the word of God and quote it upside down. And you use the word of God against God. Oh God, you said, I shall be on top and not beneath. Meanwhile, all your character, your attitude, even the way you think is under, is beneath. Do you get that? Even the way you think is underneath. And now you are using the word of God against God. Your word says I'm head and not tail. Your attitude is already tail. Confessing it doesn't change that attitude. You now have to now deliberately change that attitude by that word. Otherwise, you speak it, you won't see it. You take money and spend and squander. You squander, squander, squander. And you are now telling God, your word says, he makes me rich. He said, is the blessing of the Lord maketh rich and added no sorrow to it. The blessing of the Lord maketh rich and added no sorrow to it. And you are a squanderer. You don't know how to save. You don't know how to conserve. Everything that comes goes. And you are quoting scripture. Wakbembe. have something in your life that is contrary to what you are saying. And the devil is a smart guy. If he can't beat you by your word, he will beat you by your attitude. Anyhow, you journey. There's a kind of fight they call in my village. Gidibo, gidibo. That kind of fight, they only fight it when fight turns rough. They call it gidibo, gidibo. When fight turns rough. When you know those days when we go to play football in one particular field and then some bigger boys think that they can oppress you. Yes, they bring their own ball. Hey, all of you, take your ball out. We want to play our own. And I said, hey, but you made us here now. Why are you now oppressing us? He said, I'm talking, you are talking. You heard Zam slapping you. Then they don't give you from back again. Twah! You look at this one, look at this one. You can't handle the two of them. You close your eyes. It's called Gidibo, Gidibo. You are not fighting. It's not a, you know, yeah, it's not a target. Anywhere it meets, that is why you'll be looking for something. Anything. I'm not far for that type of person. Ah, I'm a witness. Femi, that time that they were nearly suffocating you, all you were hearing was tim, tim, tim. You had to, whatever. It is at that time you'll be biting somebody's buttons. You forgot that this is. Is for poo poo. You don't understand what I'm saying. You will forget that it's for poo. You that don't like poo poo, you will forget poo poo. Anyway, I'm about, hi, about me. Create a room and disappear. Hallelujah. Praise God. Okay, read the other part.
When you come to the place of prayer and you start to pray. And then your mind is wandering. In that place of prayer at that time, are you wasting time?
I thought you laugh now. You are wasting time now. Okay. I said, all of you, sit down. It's time to give you food. And they set the food in front. And then you now take your phone. You are now pressing from playing video game. I'm asking the writer, are you wasting time? You are hungry. They brought food. You say they brought it to the place of table and put food in front of you. The food is there. Fried rice, hot, and the thing is bringing smoke with those chicken that behave like this. You know those type on top. And then you now bring out your phone. You are now playing video game. I'm asking you, are you wasting time? That is not the question. You are wasting time. Your mind is wandering. Huh? Even Philemon, the book of Philemon, Paul wrote to them. He said, without your mind, without your mind, will I do nothing. Your mind is not involved. I'm wasting time. Well, your video game that they play video with you. If it's the kind of dog we have in our area, I want you to join giant. You will not know whether you are wasting time or not. You are wasting time. If your mind is not involved in anything, excuse me, are you wasting time? You are wasting time. You are wasting time. Anything you are doing as a student, lecturer is in front and he's talking, and then you are looking through the window, those who are playing ball on the field. Are you wasting time?
Yes, sir.
You are wasting time. Yeah, go ahead, sir. Praise God.
When you are specific and believe you would have what you pray for,
yeah,
but did not get it or have it, what is the reason?
You should know now. You said you are specific and you didn't get what you are asking for. What is the reason? See, there is none of us who is asking God for anything and has not received it and doesn't know the reason. I want to give you that one scripture that we used for that to answer your question. I think I talked about it some days back, some weeks ago. He said, examine yourself whether you are in the faith. Examine yourself. You will know now. Okay, you have offense against somebody. Since that last quarrel, you have not forgiven or let the matter go. And you are not asking me why your prayer is not answered. You should know. Does the Bible not say when you stand praying, do what? Forgive. Did you forgive? You should know. And some other times you come to the place of prayer and you are there, you are beating the air. Off point. They call it OP when I was in school. When a lecturer take your script, you have written 3 pages and they put diagonal. No diagonal line. The 2 red arrows. And put OP. Out of point. This is your issue and you are praying this issue. Along from low, from low, from low. And God says, oh, Mokotoshio. Your real matter, you don't know. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. That money because of Juko Korolosho. This is the problem God has been trying to deal with. You think everything about your life is money. James what? James 4. Yeah, James 4. You ask amiss. That's why you don't receive. He says sometimes you even ask to receive so that you can consume upon your lust. And some other people want to ask and receive to go and boast before others. Shorter, can you see that God is not only in your compound, he's also here. And then some other people are completely ignorant. Yes, completely ignorant. This is how they pray. He has issue that he want to pay house rent. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done as it is, and deliver and forgive us our trespasses as it is. House rent, you want to ask God for house rent, our Father, give us a day, attention, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive us, and deliver us, and deliver us, amen. Did you pray? Only I prayed. Or some others who are becoming here or being in other places where there's little life and spirit. They just get here. The issue is there. Be your house rent. Shalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalabalab He's just chalabala, bala, 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 bala. He's engaging. The spirit just, it's like putting on generator. That the generator is working doesn't mean you have current. In all my wallet. Lord, any switch, change of that switch in Leini. Until the 4 liter petrol, we. Alora me, bovas. That's it. Something is missing. He's not interested in finding out. Again. One person with knowledge will come to that house. Or walk on him. Boom! And the other. Light! Your ignorance can be your problem. Don't ask me what is the problem. Ignorance, number one. So let's leave it like that. Praise God. So you are not, you are the one who go and find out what ignorance you have. Yes, what ignorance you have. God gave you husband. You turn the husband to boyfriend. After you are now tired, you are not looking for husband. You didn't get my joke. God brought husband to you. You are trying to form level. But if I just say yes, then I pay more cheap. I'm not cheap. Listen to me. I'm not interested in you. First one, I'm not interested in you. Second one, I'm not interested in you. Everybody, I'm not interested in you. Holy Spirit, move me now. Bring my husband. You have used your husband as boyfriend. Kole. I'm just being practical with you. Some people have been married long time before now. But you know their problem? The person who came to talk to them didn't look like the husband they have in their mind. It is that your mind, go, that is the problem. Because God is bringing to you a raw material that you too, you are supposed to invest upon to convert to a finished product. You say, no, I don't want raw material. I want a long show go. If it's a long show go, but a long show go, come. Is that somebody look and say, you know what? I want to marry somebody like Reverend Ken. Only, only, only. See, do you know where I'm coming from? Do you know investment upon investment upon investment that make me look like fine boy? Only. See, we should appreciate the person who saw me when I had no form and no comeliness. When I had only one jeans trouser and three t-shirts. But they change here. Oh, there is future. Boy, what about that boy in the future? Oh, they touch me by everything to our balance. Only, only, only. You to work on your own. When God bring raw material, identify it. He may not have a car today. See car in 5 years' time. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The problem with many sisters is that they want finished product in 2021. You to have your own contribution to it, to that life, to make that life a finished product. Otherwise, the one that came with car key to your house will sell it to do wedding. Everything I have in my house and in my life is Mr. and Mrs. Because she knew me when I had nothing. So I cannot say, don't touch that television. You know, I bought it. I or we? We bought it. We are blessed. That is how God helps people. So even if you have made mistakes in the past, God can turn things around for you. But from now, don't make mistake again. Don't look at people and look. Just look at them and look them. He was in me. Kill a record, you know? My pinu. My pinu. I lock all down. See, do no conclusion. Amen. What he was. Some sisters will talk, and by the time they finish talking, the brother will just say, "We shall meet again. We shall meet." Repeat to God, "We shall meet." Can you move alive? Because a sister talk to you, Madalong, you are beautifully and wonderfully made. There will be somebody that will appreciate you for who you are. Amen. 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 For who you are. Agbe, sorry, man. I'm telling you, I'm Agbe Akiri. I'm telling you. I'm not managing my marriage. And I'm not enduring it. I'm not enduring. Because I chose well. Do you understand? That is how it should be. So all your long shogo sisters, may God have mercy, amen. Amen. And bring you to Sur Lere. Irewan in Sur. Irewan Bel. Yes. Get a brother, clean him up. Invest into his life. And then present him and say, "This is my husband." Yeah. It's better than to be waiting for that one that is already made. Already made. Wala, I'm telling you, there's wala with already made. You no, already made. Tobani wala. No tailor to take it to. Tani tailor to so. If this cloth has problem, we know the tailor. But if you buy ready made, tobani problem. That love it before. Hey Joe, I think God has spoken to somebody. Yes, sir. You hear that? Amen, I receive it. You are blessed and by the Spirit. Let's take one more, our time is up. Some people say, Reverend, continue with that lofting, eh? That lofting, eh? Don't worry, we are coming for singles alive. Yes, sir. And couples alive. Then we will flow, amen. Praise God. Take one more, sir. A good one, no? Not the one where that God is angry with me if I don't pray.
Is it good for a believer that has not come to full stature of Christ to go about to pray for the oppressed or demon-possessed or a sick person What if the spirit in them comes after him? What should we do before we can do that ministration and be safe from attack?
I like that question. It's a very sincere question. I can feel the sincerity. Truth of the matter is that fear is an enemy. God doesn't want to have fear. Timothy, Paul wrote to Timothy and said, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, but he has given us the spirit of power, love, and sound mind. So don't give room for fear. Even if you are a believer, you just got born again, it doesn't matter. Don't give room for fear. At the same time, and that scripture says, wisdom is profitable to direct. You will know wisdom by its fruits. Understand that as we have in our kingdom, so we also have in the kingdom of darkness. There are hierarchies. Okay, but there's one scripture I like. I will quote it for you and it will bless you. He said, for in 1 Corinthians, he said, for God will not allow the temptation greater than you to come to you. He will not allow it. He said, but with the same temptation, he will make a way of escape that you might be able to bear it. See? So this is the way it operates. You are supposed to grow. We call it fruit faith. What did I call it? You know, 1 John 5:4 says, for this is the victory that overcomes the world. Even is our collective faith, though, is different from the scripture that says, for he has dealt to every man among you the measure of faith. So everybody has a measure of faith. Another one says, do not do anything above your measure of faith. Meaning that you are the one that is creating problem when you don't know your measurements. The question sounds funny, but I like it. You should be able to assess yourself. You should be able to know your measurement. Do you understand? So if you look at a demon, is it demon possessed, said? Oppressed, somebody sick, an oppressed person, and you look at it. If his sickness is still okay, if his sickness, you pray in faith. God is the healer. Jesus is the healer. Your own is to pray in faith. So all of you, doesn't matter your level, attempt any case by faith. Any case of sickness, please, don't beat a retreat. I've tried the first thing. In the name of Jesus, I pray and I command that the healing of Jesus come to you. His word says, by his stripes you were healed. Institute the judgment written in Psalm 149. Bring that to it and leave it like that. Jesus will heal him. Amen? Come on, amen?
Amen.
But in the case of demon possessed, that is where you should now come to. Wisdom is profitable to direct. Because it's a demon possessed case, the demon is also alive somewhere inside that vessel. You are supposed to be alive in Christ, because the book of Acts says it is in him, in Christ, you live. It is in him you move. It is in him you have your being. Right? Now you are not a demon possessed person. Please be led. The Bible says, do not lay hands on anybody hastily. Don't try it. Don't say, we all have authority. You'll be surprised that you are the one that they will lay hands on. Because there are levels. Right? That doesn't stop you from staying here and rebuking a devil. And say, in the name of Jesus, is it 1 John 4:4 also? In the name of Jesus, you foul spirit, the Lord rebuke you. You can do that. But when it comes to coming close to lay hands and start asking them questions, how many are you? Don't do that. You hear me? Don't do that. I think I've balanced. Is it clear to you? You will know. You will know a case. For example, there's one madman in front of your house. Always mad. You see those mad people, eh? They are legion, some of them. Legion. There are many inside. You don't just say, ah, Reverend Ken has taught us that. Who Bruce? Ayayaya! Woo! Today, this madman, I free you. Then you now jump out. You now go and meet him. I saw one on Facebook. We didn't know who was casting out devil from who. The madman was, hey, hey. The woman will land, the man will land. Only it here. Owadija on the street. For Bobotini, he didn't want shame. Otwadikwe, kini efedi tiju, shekete. People already got, hey, a minister of God or child of God want to cast out devil. Otikwa glory, otikwa cast out devil, yo. Otikwa glory, people have gathered. Kofekuro, there is a time to beat retreats. You have tried it a few times and nothing happened. Just say, Maleboske, Frene Hekasa. Thank you, Jesus. Because you are in control. And strolling, you have not committed sin. You have not committed sin because God didn't send you to the whole world. There's a particular world he has sent all of us to. Find out your world. If you go into another person's world where they need anointing to deal with, let the anointing speak to you. And don't go and be zealous and enter into any shrine and just pick cutlass. Today, this tree, I'm bringing it down. You guys should be free in the name of Jesus. I'm not going to keep. It's called overzealousness. The tree may fall, bam, and your hand will go like this. And you'll be wondering, is God powerless? No, you shall change you. It's not as if God is. He said, God is able to keep you wherever he has sent you. Because anywhere there is no grace, there will be disgrace. Find out whether you have grace for it. If not, don't try and prove levels. Nobody will give you a trophy if you run mad. I know some brethren who want to claim glory. He said, we are giving glory to God. He run you. Okay, if it is to God, you have tried your own. Because she said, I'm aloleni. If it is to God. But no, Kodilo. He has seen people gathering, like the madman I talked about. He saw people gathering, Otiwa fi hai. Yes. The one thing I want, Ayo Babalawashi ati Riambonke. Temiti ba mi bae, now in the name of Jesus. Otiwa bere bae, ofe ba glory. He lay hands on the madman. The madman lay hands on him back. Lay hands on him. There was a story I heard. After a particular program in a particular church, the man had told them, you can do it. There is nothing you cannot do. You know, when we preach, we say many things. It's good to create balancing. Amen. There's nothing you cannot do. And then, two brothers, on the way home, rain fell. They now saw a madman at the junction. They now remember what pastor preached. Let us try it out. In the name of Jesus. And they lay hands. Bah! Come out! And the madman said, have you taken permission from the king? Very simple question. Two of them look and say, king. Which king? That is it. Distraction came in. They lost focus. They started asking which king. The madman and the devil inside knew that. I was sons of Sceva. These are sons of Sceva. Sons of Sceva. They started asking, who is the king? Before they gave answer to that question, the madman turned and gave one of them a dirty slap on his ear. All he heard was toe, and the ear went deaf. They had to rush him from there because the church was not far. They rushed him from there back to the church. He now became the prayer point. Ashe Juni. Don't try and form levels. See, angels will not bring trophy to your house. Hey, son of God. Ah, today, you show those devil pepper. Come and sit down and eat. Eat fruit. But you are also going to grow. When you grow to a level, you now come to realize that there are all devils are under your feet. You hear me? But in the interim, God protects you from those devils. I am talking from the Bible. You think you are the one. God is the one protecting you. He keeps you away from them. He knows them. Angels know them. Holy Ghost knows them. Jesus knows them. They keep you away from them. Because they know that you have not yet. One day the man, Archbishop Benson Dahosa, was preaching on a crusade ground. And he had told everybody, bring dead people. So people went to the mortuary and brought dead. So the man stood in front, preaching. There is nothing Jesus cannot do. Jesus the same yesterday, today, and forever. Those people went behind. The usher said, what are you doing? He said, you people said we should bring dead people. And this man, we brought him from the mortuary. He said, our brother. They didn't stop at the back. They said, take him to the back. No. We need this stage. They now brought him to the stage. It was a life crusade. Brought him to the stage and put the dead man there. Usher tried to stop them. He couldn't stop the people that brought the dead man. They couldn't stop them. This was a testimony from Baba himself. He saw the drama, but he didn't want to get distracted. The Lord, he can do it. They brought him back. He said every time he turned, his heart went. You don't know it. If you know what preachers are facing, his heart went. And then because man of faith, and he continues firing. He looks back again. It was like Satan was taunting him. Look back. Look back. Look back. You say your God can do it. Look back. And the man will look back. But he began to preach. So every person who does miracle ministry, there's one secret about miracle ministry. They look for what we call key. There's something called key. Key is, it could be headache. That will be the key that will open the miraculous for that service. You don't start with the big one. So he just saw that key and went there. Mahamashka, in the name of Jesus. Come! And there was miracle and crowd shouted, glory be to God. When he saw the crowd, his faith rose. Then he felt that fear and said, remove the cloth. Don't try it. listen to me. It doesn't mean God is not God, but God is not frivolous. The day Jesus healed that man that was there, that woman that had been there for 38 years, she was not the only person there. There were many other sick folks by the pool of Bethesda. Jesus got there and healed only one. He had power to heal all of them, but it was only one that God wanted him healed. And that was it. So we don't try. We have learned that years ago. We don't prove any point. It is those who have not come to ministry who want to prove point. When you are in this thing that I'm doing, you wait for him. It's his job. At the end of the day, he takes the glory. I'm not going to kill myself. Stay where I am. The one he has given to me, I know that level. I just be functioning there. You don't stretch. He said that day he just turned. I said, listen, this dead man, the same thing God did to that man there, is doing here. Everybody turned that amen. The point is that all of them now had faith. He's now leveraging on the faith of everybody that this man will be healed. And then he turned, lay hands. Meanwhile, again, he also had experiences before. He has raised a dead person before. Leveraging on that, I'm praying for this one. He said, suddenly the man sneezed and sat up. the whole stadium went thunderous. Then he said to them, I told you my God can do anything. At that point, it was all glory to Jesus. So please, don't go beyond. And sometimes we also need reinforcement. If you get a circumstance or a situation where you cannot run away, where you cannot dodge, maybe your mother just started doing something. You, family. Yes. What do? Call for reinforcement. That is also, it's called joint prayer, prayer of agreement. At least it's not a crusade ground. Abi, call for a reinforcement. And then I will join faith with you, address that issue, and then leave the rest to God. Is that okay? I think we are blessed. Can you rise up to your feet this morning? Thank you. It's been wonderful. We give praise to Jesus. Oh, give him praise and appreciate him. Thank him because all things are possible. There's